Hello. Oh, hello. No, I think it more expedient if you don't mention my name. Not on the telephone. Nor do I want you to come up to my room. You are quite clear what you have to do. Well, give him a really hard sell. I mean, he's a tycoon. He'll understand a hard sell. Yes. The tools for the job. Oh, certainly, I've obtained them, yes. Mannlicher? Magnum, of course. A 2020 scope. It'll be waiting for you at the front desk in 1 hour from now. In a plain wrapped cover, of course. Use it well, my friend. But of course you would. I'm told you're the best salesman in the business. Yeah. With a bit of luck, you should make a killing. Yes, a big killing.
Fish alone, Sonny.
Did you tell him I'm here?
You're frightening them. You're just frightening them.
How is he?
Will you please leave the fish alone?
Nearly got you that time, Goldie.
Should you be drinking this early?
Oh, I'm not drinking early. I'm drinking late. I'm still on last night's Jack. I won't get started on today's drinking till 3 or 4 o'clock this afternoon.
Check those. Where's Harry Tallman?
Los Angeles. He arrived there last night.
Call him.
Well, he'll be sleeping. He got there very late.
Call him. Tell him I want him here for Wednesday's meeting.
Hello, Dad.
Sonny! I didn't know you were here. It's good to see you. You look fine.
I feel fine.
Great to see you. Why didn't you tell me he was here?
Oh, we made a pact not to disturb you.
Oh, well, how was Switzerland? Plenty of skiing?
Jamaica.
Oh, yeah, Jamaica. Water skiing, eh? Plenty of girls? Good time?
It was fine.
Yeah, I want to hear all about it. We'll have lunch. Can you make lunch?
Yeah, of course.
You're lunching with Sir Bernard today.
Oh, yes. I can't dodge that.
Dinner, perhaps.
No, I'm making a speech at some trades fair. I can't dodge that, either.
No, of course you can't, Dad. You couldn't dodge
that. Oh, this is ridiculous. If only I'd known you were coming.
Oh, look, it's my fault, Dad. I should have cabled you. You look tired, Dad. You've been overdoing it.
Oh, not more than usual. Well, that'll be my private phone. Don't go away. Yes?
He could see you for lunch on Saturday.
Yeah. Could fit me in, could he?
Sonny.
Well, they should have some fun, too. Everyone should. Look, ask him to call me, will you? Tried to kill you, Dad. Someone tried to kill you.
The picture was called High Sierra, and it starred Humphrey Bogart.
James Cagney.
It was Humphrey Bogart. I remember it perfectly. I took the girl next door to see it. We were having quite a torrid romance at the time.
A torrid romance? Well, you weren't even 10 years old when that picture came round for the second time.
I advanced from puberty earlier than most.
I know. Your brother warned me.
I've had my moments.
Moments? The way I heard it, you and the girl next door spent your entire youth in the back row of the cinema.
Yes. And her name was Veronica, as in Lake. Beautiful.
Arden, love you as I do, you are digressing deliberately because when it comes to old movies, you are a complete slouch.
Personal abuse does not alter the fact that I have an encyclopedic knowledge of the silver screen.
It was James Cagney.
It was Humphrey Bogart, don't you remember?
Bogey came in, curled his lip. Peter Lorre said, "You despise me, don't you, Rick?" And Bogey came back with, "If I gave you any thought, I suppose I would. I'm sick of all you sleek-eyed slobs looking down your nose with your shiny shoes and your pocket handkerchiefs."
That was good. Really, very good. Oh, and incidentally, you're both wrong. It was Bogart, but the movie was Casablanca.
I don't believe we've met, Blue Eyes. I'm Arden Buckley. This is my wife, Susie.
Hello, Susie. You don't mind if I call you Susie?
Well, I'd mind much more if you call me George.
What can I do for you?
Hit him. Well, he didn't fall right down. I was just finding out how tough you really are, Mr. Buckley.
Oh, that's all right then. But for a moment there, I was afraid you didn't like me. You see how they both fell right down? Does that mean I win?
It means that you're hired.
Not if it's divorce. We never handle divorce.
My name is Henry Garrick. Most people call me Sonny. I have a very sweet disposition.
Who's your friend?
Oh, Breck. He's a sort of chauffeur, valet, guardian. My father gave him to me for my 13th birthday. Look, could I have a drink? Listen, you are very expensive.
Well, we will be if you keep pouring scotch like that.
I'd hate to employ anyone cheap.
Oh, naturally.
My father is David Garrick. You've heard of him, of course.
The actor?
Industrialist. Millionaire.
Self-made millionaire. Don't forget the self-made. He likes that. Oh, he works very hard. Always has. Left these shores many years ago and went to Canada, where he acquired his first fortune under Canadian accent. Then he spent a large chunk of that fortune sending me to expensive schools so that I'd lose the accent that he had acquired. Don't you think that's funny?
No, not really. Well, I mean, it's just my story in reverse. I left America and found my fortune here.
She's crazy about Irishmen.
No, not all Irishmen. Just you. And Patrick. And Sean. And Cyril.
So your father works very hard. What about you?
Oh, I don't work very hard. In fact, not at all. Except water skiing, escorting the world's most beautiful women. Give me another couple of years, I'll be a fully-fledged alcoholic.
Oh, another self-made man.
I love my father. Did I tell you that?
What do you want from us, Sonny?
Really love him. Only this morning, someone tried to kill him. Find out who, Mr. Buckley. Find him for me.
Does your father have any enemies?
I have some.
Any friends?
Well, I have some of those, too. Sonny, who are these people? What are they doing here?
Susie and Arden Buckley, my father. Dad, these people are going to find out who shot at you.
Well, that is already taken care of. My corporation employs a security organization, and they're already working on it. I'd like my chair then, Sonny. I've got some calls to make.
Look, Dad, these people are the best. Let me do this my way. It matters to me.
All right, you're hired.
Thank you.
Now, let me get on with my call, Sonny. I'll talk to you later.
Oh, they're pretty. What are they?
Dipsomaniacs.
Left Garrick, you disappeared into thin air. I was about to start a suit for desertion.
In the face of the enemy? I went to check out the building the shot came from.
Hey, that's very good, Arden. What did you find?
Well, there were 23 rooms that could have been used. 22 of them were filled with workers at the time of the shot. And in the 23rd...
You found a demented man whose business Garrick had ruined, crouching over a smoking rifle, babbling a confession. What we call in the trade a lucky break.
I found nothing. The cupboard was bare. Bears out my theory.
When did you start having theories?
This job has all the hallmarks of a professional.
the fact that there are no hallmarks. Why are you looking like that?
That's my oligarch with admiration, though. Don't you like it?
No.
What are you going to do next?
Well, I also did some checking up on Garrick. There is a woman in his life.
Oh, so there should be in everyone's.
Even the women's? Now, this woman's called Leonora Gale. Garrick has been escorting her to public places for some time now.
Escorting?
Amongst other things. Oh. She's attractive, sophisticated, terribly sexy. I'm going to see her now.
I'll get my coat.
No, I'm going alone.
Alone?
Susie, don't you trust me?
Of course I don't trust you.
Good. We don't want our marriage to stagnate. Little competition keeps you up on your toes.
Just so I don't become a prima ballerina. Oh, all right. And what does your intrepid partner do while you're with this Gale woman?
I said this looks like the work of a professional. Get hold of Charlie Wilson.
The concern is very moving, but I assure you there's nothing to worry about.
There is everything to worry about. Dad, somebody tried to kill you, murder you. I don't like that. It scares me.
Scares you?
Well, you're all I've got, Dad.
Almost.
No, Dad. Just you. There's no one else.
Well, it could have been an accident, a mistake. Has that occurred to you?
A mistake? How?
Oh, somebody's cleaning a gun, it goes off, they panic, they run.
Look, that shot got you right in the middle of the forehead, Dad, except it happened to be your reflection.
Yeah, well, an unhappy coincidence.
Coincidence? You here, a sitting duck, somebody with a high-powered rifle and... What's wrong, Dad?
Scotch, it smells kind of funny.
Coincidence, Dad?
Come in. Come in, Charlie. Charlie Wilson. Come in, Charlie. We're quite alone. Everybody knows you're an informer.
Oh, no. No. They think I might be, but they don't know. There's a difference. Business, was it, Mrs. Buckley?
Yes. I need to find a hired killer.
Oh? You're going to kill someone?
No. But somebody else is, and I need to find out who. A new face in town, a whisper.
Oh, hard to say. A good pro's hard to get. Expensive, too, but worth every penny. They seldom miss.
This one did.
Well, we all have our off days, Mrs. Buckley.
Well, you try and have a good one, Charlie. Now, there will be the same again when you come back with the information tonight.
Tonight? Oh, that's an awful tall order, Mrs. Buckley. May take some time.
And you're wasting it talking to me. Talk, but the fact is I am very busy. Do sit down. Well, lie down if you're tired. Well, Mr.
Buckley. Arden Buckley. I'm a private detective.
You can't be. Where's your dirty trench coat?
It wasn't raining.
All the detectives I've ever met wore dirty trench coats.
You've met a lot of detectives.
Darling, I've been divorced 4 times. Trench coats marching into bedrooms with cameras has become a way of life. Well,
I'm a private detective.
Oh, I see, right. What was it you wanted?
You're a friend of David Garrick's.
A friend? Oh, I like you. What a nice, quaint way of putting it.
Somebody tried to murder him, or hired somebody to murder him.
I'm not surprised. Careful with the pins, there's a dear. Let's face it, darling, he's not the most lovable character one's ever met. I should think there are hundreds of people who'd like to kill him.
Including you?
Well, you are the detective, darling.
No. You were at the hairdresser's when the shot was fired.
You're not just a pretty face, are you? So I'm eliminated.
So will he be if I don't pin down who really wants him dead. And I mean really, with a strong motive.
Hate strong enough for you? Try his wife.
Wife? But his son never mentioned. I just naturally assumed he was a widower.
Oh, he'd like to be sometimes, I think. She lives in the country house.
Wife. Thanks for your help, Mrs. Gale. By the way, I think the dress is going to be a smash.
Oh, thank you, darling. I always think a girl should package the goods nicely. And call me Leonora. Or, as it's you, Lulu.
Goodbye, Mrs. Gale. Why didn't you tell me you had a wife?
Well, you knew I had a son. Anyway, it's no business of yours. I didn't hire you.
No, but he did. So why did you hold out on me?
I didn't hold out on you. You didn't ask.
You didn't volunteer.
After my stint in the army, I told him never to volunteer for anything.
One of you might have told me.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. My wife, she's a sick woman. She has nothing to do with this, and you can stay away from her.
I'm afraid it's too late for that.
Anybody home? Mrs. Garrick? Mrs. Garrick? Mrs. Garrick? Why, Mrs. Garrick? I'm Susie Buckley. I came to talk to you about your husband. Oh, you are pretty. Mm. Prettier than the others that have come here, isn't she, Emma? Mm. Mrs. Garrick, your husband has
been... We've been married a long time. Happily married, we're never apart. Even when he goes abroad on business, I always go with him. We don't like being apart.
Mrs. Garrick,
we were married when I was very young. I was a model. That's why he chose me. David always like pretty things. I was prettier than you. I was prettier than any of them. this girl say he wants to divorce me, but it's not true, you know? It's not true. It's not true. He's my husband. He loves me. You think he wants to marry you, don't you? Oh, yes, you do. Oh, yes, you do. Oh, yes, they all do. Do. All those that come. You think he loves them? He doesn't love them. He doesn't love them. He doesn't love anything. He doesn't even... needs me. I have been ill. Oh, no, yes, I have been rather ill. And I don't want David to see me until I'm better. Those girls. Because I knew there would be girls. He's very attractive. Did Sunny send you? Sunny used to come and visit me sometimes, not anymore. Not anymore. Sonny's like me. He's much more like me than like David.
I'm very sorry to have troubled you, Mrs. Garrick.
I don't know who you are, but please don't come here again. You can whine and plead as much as you like, but I'm not going to give him a divorce. You can tell him from me that my answer to you is the same as to all the others. He is my husband and I'll see him dead. Enjoy seeing, meeting. It's been most enjoyable. Most. What you've done to him.
Have you been upsetting her?
I don't know. Who are you?
Mrs. Stannard. I take care of Mrs. Garrick. Who are you? What do you want?
I'm Susie Buckley. I work for Mr. Garrick.
Oh, yes, they usually do. Secretary, typist, something like that?
Nothing like that. Someone is trying to kill Mr. Garrick, and my husband and I are trying to find out who.
Somebody trying to... There's nothing she can tell you. I think you better go now. I'm going to take her home.
Don't you live here?
No. We live in the hunting lodge. She likes to come and sit here sometimes in the afternoon. Sit and remember. They used to live here when they were first married.
She must love him a great deal.
Love him? She despises him. She can't forgive him for all the...
Yes?
She hates him.
Enough to kill him?
Oh, she's like a child. Oh, what harm could she do?
Yes. As you say. Hunting lodge. That was what you said, wasn't it? The hunting lodge.
Yes.
They'd keep guns there, wouldn't they?
I know I can't persuade you to be careful, Mr. Garrick, but I do beg you to take this seriously.
Nobody's gonna touch me while Brett's around.
Taste all your food and drink, will he? What does he do against a Magnum Point 303? Field it and send it flying back?
Look, I know you're just trying to do your job.
With precious little help.
Well, I was upset. I was angry. I thought of somebody bothering my wife.
Susie won't bother your wife, Mr. Garrick. She just wants to ask a few questions.
Oh, she won't get any answers. None that make any sense.
Yeah, well, what he means is that, my wife, well, she's been under stress for some time. She doesn't always comprehend. Mr. Buckley, your wife...
Is the soul of tact and discretion.
Yeah, but if she were to go barging in there impetuously...
Impetuous? Let me tell you something, Mr. Garrick. Susie is hyper-cautious. On our wedding day, she didn't say, I do. She said, maybe.
Can I offer you a lift, Mr. Buckley?
Just to the nearest cab rank.
Sonny.
Now, I have my own car. I'll walk down with you.
Yes, it was rather acting beyond instructions, but, well, let us hope that you have scared Buckley off. Oh, by the way, I had a whisper about someone inquiring about you. Not you personally, not by name, no, but, about somebody like you. Who? Oh, his name was Wilson. Charlie Wilson.
He said he'd call later.
Who?
Charlie. Did you have a nice day?
Splendid.
Oh.
What's the O for?
Well, I can say O if I want. O. And was she attractive? Sophisticated and terribly sexy.
Eh?
Mrs. Gale.
Oh.
Ha, there, you said it. Was she?
Fantastic. I spent hours cavorting in her boudoir.
You know you shouldn't cavort, dear. It's bad for your back.
It was the hit-and-run driver who's bad for my back.
I suppose she plied you with champagne, flooded her false eyelashes and... Hit-and-run driver?
Well, partially true. He didn't hit, but he certainly run.
You?
Me. And Garrick. But mostly me.
Darling, you could have been killed.
I've made a will. 50% to my parents, the other half to the old folks' home, and the dog I leave to you.
We don't have a dog.
My parents will buy you one, out of their share.
I see.
What about Garrick's wife?
Oh, sad. Very disturbed. And with a heavy in tow.
Who's he?
It's a she, just. They live in a hunting lodge full of guns.
Oh.
Hate to meet her alone on a dark night.
I don't let you go out alone on dark nights.
Shh. 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 It's Charlie Wilson.
I don't hear anything.
Neither do I.
Well, then.
Well, when you don't hear him, that's Charlie Wilson. You see? Come in, Charlie. Now we'll find out who done it. Come on, Charlie. Don't be shy. It's just Arden and me.
Charlie?
Charlie, did you find out what we wanted to... Charlie? Charlie!
Oh, dear. As I feared, our friend has overstepped himself. Kindly dial his number for me, my dear. You know, Samantha, this business has all the marks of a fiasco about it. I do so hate a fiasco. Can be painful and unprofitable. Yes. Fiasco. I wonder where he's got to.
No, not today, thank you. We have all the guns we need. I know this looks like a vacuum cleaner, but it's actually a .906 howitzer. One move and I'll blow you out of the ground. Latest issue suction ray. I press this little button down here and it'll suck that gun right out of your hand. Deadly poison gas dispenser?
got around to it.
What are your plans for tonight?
Oh, I had planned to meet a friend.
A blonde, vivacious friend, name of Gale?
I think that's my business.
Not anymore, Dad. Mr. Buckley's brief is to look after you, Dad, and you are going to, aren't you?
Hope so.
Oh, don't hope. Be sure. Anyway, I'm off. And I feel much happier knowing that Mr. Buckley's going to be around you, Dad. Oh, look, if you get tired, need someone to take over for a couple of hours.
Oh, don't worry. The threat of flying bullets gives me incurable insomnia.
Would you like to check the seal on the bottle?
Oh, don't worry, I had it already. Where are you taking Mrs. Gale tonight?
Parsino's.
Oh, good. I like Italian food.
Car's ready when you are, sir.
A couple of minutes, Brett.
Yes, sir.
Brett, how would you like an evening off?
Sir?
Tycoonery can go to your head. She can keep a man waiting for hours and then get him making the apologies. Nice driving, by the way, Garrick. Now, why don't you sit down and make yourself comfortable while I mosey around the apartment and check it out?
Look, Buckley, I'm beginning to enjoy my...
No back chat from the servants. I'm the target tonight.
Darling, I'm sorry I'm late, but... Don't tell me the old goat can't make it, and I've got you all to myself. Oh, Brett, darling. David. It was a joke. I knew all along. It was... No, David, you can't take it back. It was a joke, truly.
What's going on?
You. You set this up.
What's happening? What's going on?
I thought I was Brett.
Good.
It was a mistake, David. A silly mistake.
Very.
David. David! You...
Now, listen, Mrs. Gale. Leonora!
Stupid,
Lulu!
Silly,
listen
stupid.
To me! That's why we swapped places. That's why.
I'd like to get something to eat. I'm hungry. Hungry? Well, even Grace Kelly had to eat sometime.
Okay.
Whoever he is, Mr. Garrick, he certainly knows your habits well.
Yeah. Well, this is one habit I'm chucking. It's expensive and overrated. Here, you may need this for your next addict.
Oh, I could kill him. I'd like to kill him.
You'll have to put your name on the waiting list.
David! Oh, no, 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 please. You tell him. Tell him it was a mistake. That damned uniform. I've never been able to resist a uniform. No, please. Please, I beg you.
Beg? You must be getting old, Lulu.
Arden stayed at his club. That's it. Arden stayed at his club. He often does. He won't be coming home now.
Nope.
He often does.
And leave a girl like you all alone. A girl like you.
But it's all sham and makeup. I look dreadful in the morning.
Long time until the morning.
Hello, sweetheart. Sorry I'm late. A day not without excitement. Susie. You look like a pig dressed for the table. Mm. It doesn't even go with your dress.
It wasn't my idea.
No?
No, it was that man's.
What man's?
The one with the gun behind you. I'd like to introduce you, but I can't. You see, he was waiting for me when I came home and...
Wrong.
Well, a girl can be wrong, can't she?
It was you I was waiting for, Buckley. But now this has to include her, too.
You're the hired gun. So you got my message?
I don't. She'd be dead before you got halfway to.
I don't want to inhibit you, Arden, but wives like me are very hard to come by.
He isn't going to shoot. If he was, he'd have done it already. After all, he's a pro, aren't you?
That's right. I came to talk. We're both pros, aren't we? And I have a job to do. I could have killed you, Buckley, a while back with the car. I could have killed you. But I chose to frighten you, that's all.
Why?
Lay off.
And let you kill Garrick the way you did Charlie Wilson.
Someone was going to kill Charlie sooner or later.
I think Charlie would have voted for later.
And as for Garrick, well, isn't dead yet, is he?
What's that supposed to mean?
I'm good. The best. If I'd wanted to kill him, I would have done. With the contract.
You fool!
But he had a gun. He was talking of killing.
He was talking about not killing.
I want a priest.
You want a doctor?
No, I'm a pro. A priest, if there's time.
Listen, there may not be time for a priest. Can you hear me? You can ease your soul with one thing. The name of the man who hired you. His name. Arden Buckley.
Good evening, sir. Rest yourself for a moment, Samantha, my dear. Shelby Grafton.
Your friend told me your name.
A friend, sir? Alas, in this declining world, I fear I am without friends, true friends.
Oh, this one's true, all right. Tall, thin, dark. He has one vital distinguishing feature. He carries guns and shoots them at people.
I am confused, sir.
You aren't confused. You are the broker, the middleman, the lout who does the hiring.
I prefer broker, sir.
Somebody wants a safe man, a driver, a killer. You organize it, arrange the fee, and cream 30% off the top.
40%? I'm not cheap, sir.
Who are you acting for when you hired a man to kill David Garrick?
My goodness, sir, you do have an inquiring mind. Now, before you contemplate using violence, let me hasten to assure you that I am a devout coward. I have an abhorrence of physical unpleasantness, particularly when practiced on my good self.
Oh, we can avoid that, if you tell me who hired you.
I have no idea, sir. You see, I employ so very many devious methods of receiving instructions, and indeed payments, that my clients remain totally unknown to me. That is the truth, sir. I swear it's the truth.
How would you like a broken arm?
Thank you, but I must decline.
Yes, you probably are telling the truth. Otherwise, you'd be blackmailing too.
But of course, I am inordinately greedy. So you accept my word?
Just.
I appreciate that. A moment of trust between two men. A rare emotion I shall cherish. I do hope, sir, you won't be embarrassed if I say I like you.
You do now, perhaps. But you won't.
I detect a threat.
You do indeed.
I don't see how or why. I mean, we've been talking of theorizing, but you have no shred of positive proof at all. In other words, there's nothing you can pin on me, Buster.
Isn't there? Oh, I forgot to mention our mutual friend, the one with the gun. He's dead.
Dead?
Exceptionally.
All okay.
And is locked into the boot of your car. The police
have been informed.
This is my wife, Susie, by the way, Shelby Grafton.
How do you know?
I thought he'd feel happier taking his last rest among friends. Besides, he was bleeding all over my carpet.
It's real Persian.
Indeed, madam, you have taste.
Oh. That's different.
Certainly beat canvas.
Thank you.
So nice meeting you.
Awfully nice.
Goodbye.
We shall continue later in Buenos Aires, if we're lucky. Oh, dear. It's going to be one of those days. Fiasco.
You ought to be in bed, Mrs. Garrick.
I had to come and make sure that everything was all right. David is bringing home some very important people to dinner tonight, and he just would like everything to be right.
I think you've made a mistake, Mrs. Garrick. It's tomorrow night. The dinner is tomorrow night.
Oh, yeah. Of course. You won't tell David, will you? He does so like to tease me. Yes, of course, it is tomorrow. And then we're going to the Bahamas on a second honeymoon.
Yes.
He does love me. That's why we're going away.
And you must come and get your beauty sleep, so that you should look especially pretty for him.
Yes, he likes me. Yes, he always wants me when I'm pretty.
You have a prospective victim.
David Garrick. And a potential killer, his wife, any number of girlfriends, business rivals, jealous husbands.
I'm not sure about killer.
Hmm?
That man, the one who expired on our carpet.
Hmm.
He was talking about not killing.
He did no such thing.
He implied it then.
Oh, that's not the same thing at all. I mean, you implied a little while ago that you were going to kiss me, but you haven't, so?
So? What?
Exactly. So what? I can live without your implied kisses, Arden Buckley, and what's more...
Of course, there's always Sonny.
I do not want to kiss Sonny.
As a suspect. Except that doesn't make sense.
Why not?
Well, he brought us in the first place. And in the second place, I checked up. He has almost $8 million of his own.
Hey, maybe I do want to kiss Sonny.
And if his father died, the corporation would undoubtedly run down. It's very much a one-man business. So if Garrick were killed, Sonny would actually be worse off. It's a puzzle.
Hey, I've got an idea.
What?
Oh, just the same old one. Do you think I might be a kleptomaniac?
What?
Well, I have this irresistible desire.
Then you must fight it. You'll get arrested.
Can they arrest you for it?
Certainly. It's a criminal misdemeanor.
Well, I shouldn't think it was anybody else's business.
What, going around stealing things?
Stealing? Who said anything about stealing?
You did. You said kleptomaniac.
Does that mean stealing?
Yes.
Must be the other maniac I'm thinking of.
Huh? Oh, nymphomaniac. Mm. An irresistible desire for men.
Well, perhaps only in the singular. That was awful.
Am I losing my touch?
Oh, no, not you, silly. That man. The one with the gun.
Did he try to kiss you?
No, but he thought about it.
You died happy then. Lucky I got back before the thought developed.
I think he was a late developer. Anyway, after I fixed him the eggs...
Eggs? What eggs?
The 6-minute ones.
Oh, so you cooked him eggs?
Yes, and toast. Well, I mean, he did have a gun.
Yes.
We sat here, and the silence was very, very awkward.
How long was he here, then?
No, he'd been here since about 4:30.
4:30? But I thought he just arrived.
No. Does it matter?
Of course it matters. Somebody took a shot at Garrick around 6:30 this evening.
Did they?
Well, me wearing Garrick's coat and hat. So it couldn't have been your man, while we were at Mrs. Gale's.
What were you doing there?
Impersonating Garrick.
Oh, really?
So, if that man was here, and someone was shooting there, there must be two men.
Don't overtax your brain, dear.
Two killers. Two hired guns. Or Brett.
Who's Brett?
The chauffeur. It's all off between Garrick and Mrs. Gale because of the chauffeur.
What did he do? Try to run them over?
The run around, sweetheart. The run around.
I knew I didn't like that woman.
You've never met her.
Well, of course not. You don't think I'm going to meet somebody I don't like, do you?
Hello, Sonny. Arden Buckley. And Susie. Listen, how can I get in touch with Brett, your chauffeur? Well, he might, just might, be our man.
So? First they give you the evening off and then they call you out again. Tomorrow's in the country.
What can he want me for now? In here, sir. I'm in here.
There's no sign of Brett.
No sign at all?
Nope. As soon as you called, I went round to his place. He hasn't been there all evening, so I sat and waited, and it's now...
4:30.
Right. Looks as though he isn't going to be back. You were right, then. He's our man.
I didn't say that.
No, but you said...
I said he might be.
Yeah, but he's gone. He's disappeared.
Couldn't he be on a late-night party?
Well, no, he's due in tomorrow, early.
We all are. Get some sleep, Sonny.
Oh, not me. I'm going to sit outside Dad's place till morning. I don't take chances.
Well, just a moment. I'll put you through.
Yes?
It's Sonny on the line, Mr. Garrick. He wants to speak to you urgently.
Put him through.
You're through.
Time. I have to see Sonny. He's up at the old house.
But this just came through.
Later, later. He's in trouble of some kind.
Is it?
A man's entitled to his little secrets, isn't he?
Unless he's married me.
Ah, Susie. Hello.
Buckley, you'd better come over here right away.
Over where? Where are you?
My father's office. He was called away just a while ago.
Called away where? Who by?
By whom?
By me.
By you? But I don't understand.
Neither do I. That's the point. Only he had this call from me saying I wanted to see him urgently. But I didn't call him, Buckley. It wasn't me.
Right. I'll be right over. Garrick's urgent. Try and get the car out of the garage without denting it.
That's unfair. I haven't dented the car all week. Shouldn't we call the police?
No. Mr. Buckley is handling this. He'll know what to do.
Outside and waiting and not a scratch on it.
Those old car tires around the doors did the trick, eh?
You only put them on to undermine my confidence.
Before you undermined our car insurance. Right?
Arden, are you putting on weight? I got this call. I thought it was Sonny. It sounded like Sonny, so I put it through to Mr. Garrick's office. And then a moment later, he rushed out saying he had to see Sonny urgently. Alone.
But I didn't call. It wasn't me.
Where was he going, did he say?
Yes, the country house.
Where Mrs. Garrick lives?
Yes.
And what did they say? At the house. Well, you've tried phoning them, haven't you? You haven't. Phone them and keep phoning them till you get him.
And when I do?
If you do, tell him to get out of there. Tell him to run for his life, understand?
think it's broken.
I'll get a doctor.
No, look, there's no time. Look, get to my father. Don't let anything happen to him. Here, look, take my car keys. My car's locked. I've dropped them. Here we are. It's much faster. It'll get you there sooner.
I've always wanted to drive one of these.
Come on.
Start on us. When you drove down there before, how long did it take?
Oh, about 5 hours.
What?
You know I have no sense of direction.
Well, how long would it take a moderately efficient homing pigeon?
60 minutes.
Let's hope Garrick is a nice, sedate driver.
Keep on trying, Mrs. Tyrrell. I'm going for a doctor.
Doctor?
Dead. Stone cold dead. Stay here. Help will come soon.
Oh. Do the 5th Cavalry use this road often?
That's an order.
Brute! Garrick! Oh, you gave me a fright. For a moment there...
You've been sabotaged.
Beg your pardon?
Cotton waste in the petrol line. Old army trick. Certain way of stopping an engine after a little while leave you stranded.
Somebody wanted to stop Sonny.
Sorry?
So am I. To have put you to all this trouble.
No trouble.
Actually, I have a very good working knowledge of cars. I could have probably fixed it myself, except for one small thing.
Oh, what's that?
I don't know how to open the hood.
I'm glad about that.
Would you mind?
Hello?
What are you doing here? Where's Sonny?
Sonny denies making that call, Mr. Garrick.
But it was him, I'm sure it was.
It was whoever wants to kill you. They wanted you down here alone.
Whoever?
Your wife lives in the lodge nearby, doesn't she?
Yeah.
Hard. Listen, I want you out of sight and undercover, Mr. Garrick.
Don't be ridiculous. I'm going to see this thing through to the end with you.
Oh, dear. I can see I'm going to have trouble with you.
I'm prepared to see this thing through and face...
Sorry about this, Mr. Garrick. I just don't have the time.
It's a foul up all round.
Arden!
Pity.
You!
I didn't want it this way. Believe me, it wasn't planned this way. A car was supposed to break down. I was supposed to be here before. You should all have been over by now. Even the ankle was planned. You have to be in good condition to fake a fall like that. I didn't want to kill him.
But you did. You did! You hired someone to kill your own father.
No, I hired him to miss my father. I get to kill him. But all the other business, it muddles up the issue, don't you think? Takes all the blame off me. I shall have to kill you, too. I didn't plan that.
I don't care.
Oh, it was going to be so nice, too. Neat. A switch of plan that would have worked. I went to be so much trouble getting Brett here, too. Wasted. It was going to look as though Dad killed Brett out of jealousy, then himself. Dad. Arden must have hidden him away somewhere. He must be here. He couldn't have got away. I was watching. He must be here somewhere.
Sonny?
Yes, Dad.
Why? I've given you everything.
Given and taken, Dad. You've got to be stopped once and for all.
Stopped?
Look at me, Dad. Look at me! Are you proud of what you see? A drunkard, a waster, a no good? Well, you should be proud, Dad, because you made me.
You've had every chance.
Oh, yes. Yes, I've started businesses. Things I wanted to do, things I might even have been good at. And what happened, Dad? You made sure that your friends were my customers. They didn't want me, Dad. They just wanted to keep in with you.
I wanted to help.
No, Dad. You wanted me beholden to you. You wanted to shape destinies, to play God. You wanted to stay king. Well, you've had a long reign, Dad, and now you've got to be stopped before you destroy me the way you destroyed Mother. You gave her everything, didn't you? You shaped her destiny. I can't ever be anything while you're still alive, Dad. Your shadow's got too big, too dark.
You'll be a success at this, Sonny. You see, I don't believe you can even do this right. I didn't make you a failure, Sonny. You always were. It's in your nature. But prove me wrong. Shoot me.
No!
No, don't worry, Mrs. Buckley. He doesn't have the guts, do you, Sonny? You've had everything. Education, opportunity, yes, you've even had love. And there's just one basic vital factor missing. That that turns a boy into a man. Go ahead, Sonny. Go.
Why not? He killed Brett, and he killed me.
And I hit you. 3 times at least I hit you.
How did you do it?
Bulletproof vest. I haven't actually bought it. I've just had it sent on approval.
Well, I approve. I certainly do approve. But what made you put it on at that particular moment? I mean, which clue was it? Did Sonny betray himself in some subtle way? You sensed you were walking into danger. Instinct, hunch, the mark of the true professional.
It was none of those things.
But what was it then?
Well, you know me. When I get something new, I just can't resist it. I have to put it on immediately.
Oh, Arne, you flabbergast me.
That seems like a good idea.